Before we start, we've got a public service announcement. Mark got some raffle tickets in the middle of foster care.
Foster tickets that have been provided by raffle tickets for kids who are in foster families, foster children, who are a bit of a break. So, students foster families.
So, that's how much,
yeah,
although it's false, we can give it to that. First item this morning's agenda. What about the apologies? Has any members got any interest in that?
No.
Also, there's a positive. Minutes, everyone have any differences in the minutes from last meeting? Yeah? Everyone have any disagreements?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, the next item is the scrutiny review good practice guide. Basically, this is a guidance document which is approved by the coordinating committee a few years ago, so I'll just invite the members if you have any comments.
I know it's been discussed with full council. Probably one of the things missing from this document is what happens to the recommendations at the end of a review. I think there needs to be some agreements around developing a tracking system. Once a recommendation has been agreed by the executive, there's a tracking system to make sure that's followed through. So I'd like to add a recommendation to this report that that is actually put into place at the moment. I don't think this is actually a good practice guide at the moment to add full circle. Perhaps a full circle down to the
so just in terms of that report, because it was agreed by the committee, the committee's been reviewed.
No, Chair, I mean, it's really good to have to
in the sense that all the reports I've read so far have been detailed from alcohol right through to issues about care and hospital study of care that have been written last night. I'm interested though about the opportunity. Let's suppose that Thurow Norwood, member of our scrutiny panel, didn't agree with all the findings in the sense that it does talk about part of a sign off of the report. I'm not quite sure what sign-off actually means, in the sense that we all met together over many meetings like the health board did. I was involved in about 15 sessions where they did research and met. But at the outcome of all that, the main occasion, it's occasion to be something where an individual member is not sure about a particular recommendation, in which case how would it build into the system an idea that there should be a minority report and isn't quite agreeable with, say, particular 15 or 18 recommendations. There might be something a member wasn't quite convinced about who thought more work should be done. So how would that be addressed? And what I read into sign off on page 10, second bullet point, that, and I'm not sure how sign off means that the members went into something and had a view. If they, when they meet the accountable officer and the portfolio holder, and this isn't quite the same feel towards being there in order, how we would address that interesting situation.
Some of the way from the previous group of reviews is we've invited all members to have a
paragraph of comment. So any differences they could highlight within that, or any put parts of the report that they felt more critical of others, they could use that text to highlight it. So it could reflect them.
There's no reason why the report couldn't seek to include a different caveat if a member raises a concern or issue, so that the report captured any concern or representations that a member or member wished to make qualifying a particular recommendation or particular.
Thank you, Chair. First, a helpful comment on that one, Chair. Given that that possibility exists, or is understood to exist, then Chair.
These are just the regular exception reports, and all three of them involve the specific area of the personal finance unit which I'm responsible for, and detail the up-to-date position as at the end of November of where we're up to with these three targets, all of which are signed red, and in the actual action plan templates we've explained what work is going on in each of those to remedy that as much as we can during the rest of the financial year. Happy to take a question on any of those.
My question wasn't about these three things, about the fact that there's actually four red indicators, P29, self-serve back to schools is also on a red. Continue to roll out the first phase, self-service. Need to consider revisiting rollout of self-service schools in light of system changes. Not be possible to consider a further an action plan. That was really my question before Malcolm came.
Chris, do you?
It wasn't a really good question. I heard about self-service schools. P29, which is self-serve to schools, the rollout of the
we've wanted. We're trying to keep it at that high level, so that the monitor that was absolutely critical to the audience value. It doesn't mean to say that we limit the reporting of viewers of the views in terms of security purposes. So we keep it to those high level indicators.
So is everyone happy with the rest of us to test us by email? Is everyone happy?
It's about DP6 on page 3 to do with complaints. The year-to-date performance seems to be hard to make
at the more questions, I'll just go to the message from Martin Moss.
Thank you, Chair. The reason for the Greens that that's the overall status that I think for the vast majority of the year we have been in topic, as we said, the narrative comes from states that the target will be the response rate increased to 15 days in November for that particular month, and that's been reflected in the position. The arrow, as I appear there, is still overall the monthly trend is positive, but it does the for November is represented by that minus sign. For that particular month, there has been a response rate below the or above the target rate, and that's been reflected in the status as shown. So overall, it is still green. So we anticipate it's still to be green, and with the target for the forecast for the year, understanding November's figures being below the target level.
I mean, nothing's tragically given here, and I probably appreciate that. I just think, you know, if you start to read some of the text, 29 days to response, 20 days to response, 20 days to response, and then worry there is an issue here. If you just scan read things, the colour guide is going to be quite helpful. I'm not sure if it was desperately helpful. There seems to be a problem emerging there. Now, you're right, you have got a minus here in your trend, but you know that. That's significantly over, isn't it? Four extra days of the claims on average is quite high. So I just wonder if the comments on around why you think that's going to come back online.
It is being monitored and steps taken to address that at the moment, but the information we have, we are forecasting to be on trend and the overall status will be as planned and as targeted, it is set. In the event that there is a shift from that or deviation from trend,
and is there any comment on why some departments are taking nearly a month to respond to the claim on the target is
I'd have to come back to the question because I don't have questions.
I'll stand there if those are some questions regarding the exceptions to the housing element.
It's a simple one of understanding language information. On page 27, in the non-compliance reason for the personal finance unit assessments, the careful word chosen is debate. Debate continues without the social services, etc. I'm not sure what constitutes debate. At worst, it means grabbing people by the scruff of the neck and shaking them all out. And at least it's sort of quiet tap on the shoulder or a critical frame somewhere in between. So it would be interesting to know what we understand by the state of play, in the sense that the past where we used to have what was an audit, we used to have audit recommendations that were agreed in whole or in part, there was sort of something behind something not being agreed. So perhaps we could understand whether adult social services staff sort of agree entirely in not simply roll over and have their tummy tickled, but what is the state of debate?
This is obviously a reflection at the end of November, and this was at the point where we were in discussions with DAS as to the impact that their work and our work had on each other. And obviously, our response timescales and their response timescales, because both of us worked together to actually be able to make an assessment for some of these domicile and residential care units. At that point, there were a number of outstanding issues that we needed to discuss and also get advice on as to how that would affect some of these assessments. And this was specifically about how we can improve with our staffing, both in adult social services and ourselves, what was the best way. And that's actually gone on since that time, because again, some of our staff are looking at how we help DAS improve their turnarounds, because they do the initial work followed by us then doing secondary assessment, meeting with people, making the assessment and assessing the charge. But we are dependent on the adult social services people doing their information, and when we have queries, they obviously have access to the information that my staff clearly not allowed access to, and to try and get that back. And again, clearly as it indicates, it's that both on the quality of inputs, it's not related with the layers, whether or not we do it, or they do it, and also the response time scales, because again, like all of our staff and all of our students, we have many competing questions to what we have to do to try and make sure we do address this one, to one, it is a red, and we're looking at all the issues that make it a red to try and bring it back first to Amber and then to.
Just looking at page 23, just some clarification at the bottom. It says system live in January 2014. Is that that the system is live or will be live? That's the current status on that. And just a second question, just a general comment on 25 and 27. Is it ever possible to get the dates of when things are likely to move on to 23 rather than just the comment? Thank you.
With the second question with regards to dates, yes, we'll take that on board and try and give you assessments as to when it is likely that we will see that improve. So yes, we can do that one. With regards to the direct debit one, this was a two-part area of work, which is first our colleagues in IT had to make the system, have it on the systems live. The answer to your question is yes, it is live, we are able to use it, letters will be going out next week, what we call the next billing rule, which will invite people of a specific area with regards to residential care as to whether or not people can actually now pay on direct debit. Those letters will go out, as I say, next week. And we invite people. That doesn't mean that we will be using direct debit, because we have to have you signed up and monitor it, but letters inviting people will go out next week.
Thank you.
Thank you, Chair. Now, on page 27, it says action is what is required, and you've got new staff trained, operational, and gaining experience. Is that new staff in your department or in that sort of?
It's our staff. We have brought a new way of working within our personal finance units. New staff have been brought in, been trained to be able to go out, as I mentioned in the previous question, to a
front desk.
When we report at the end of December, the action template you will get, which clearly, because we're now at the end of January, we are compiling for the next committee, we'll split that into the current and historic debt.
Thank you very much.
Any
more questions? Thanks, Mark.
Thanks.